that my wife bought many years ago, that people tried to take from us on Janu Mathenge Road, a few plots from my own Kwacha office, that plot, which we went in 2018 to complain that there are some fraudsters who are taking it away, that suddenly now we are the culprits. I want to tell you here now, I'm not even a director or shareholder. I don't even exist in that company. But I want to add one other thing. There is a previous police report from the same DCI that is lodged in court that charges the culprits. So you wonder, what are these things that are coming up all of a sudden? It has nothing to do with the property. Just like guns a few years ago. It has nothing to do with guns or properties or anything like that. It is purely just a persecution. These are lies. Lies about crimes we know nothing about.
Could you probably be leaking it that the DCI is hitting back at you because of the court case about the guns?
If he wants to be petty, that is up to him. He can be as petty as he wants. Right now, the DCI is a convict. He has no rights to put anybody in handcuffs.
But you're in handcuffs.
Yes, he has no right. And the courts will adjudicate that. He is a convict. He was convicted last year. He's the one who should be in committee. He was even sentenced. This is just total rubbish. I think that may be part of it, but I don't think it's all of it. There is a bigger picture here, and it has to do with elections. After all, why is it every election, it is Jimi that is sought? 2017, I'm being looked for. 2022, now suddenly. In between that, there's no problem. It is about the elections.
Are you financing someone?
I am making the election very uncomfortable for some people. So let us see what is going to happen.
Are you financing someone in
2022? I have my own campaign to finance. I've got nobody to finance but myself. Thank you very much.
Were you just about to launch anything presidential with regards to your campaigns
or
something?
Yes, I was. This weekend, we were about to launch a national, delegate congress where we had called about 2,000 people, delegates of ODM, to give notice, 21 days notice, as per the constitution of the party, for a delegate congress to elect the president of the party within 21 days. That was to happen this coming weekend on Sunday.
Thank you.
Okay, you talked some duress during the almost 24 hours past 24 hours.
No, you know the greatest thing about injustice, let me tell you, is that you have peace of mind. So there's no duress.
Were you in a bunker?
No, why would I be in a bunker? Please. Please speak to us. Let me talk to them. You did not give me a chance. Let me talk to them. You are not going to push me. I'm sorry.
Please proceed.
I also know my rights. My rights are right here. You have ignored them. Please. You have ignored them. My rights are here and you have ignored them. So kindly step aside. Step aside. Now,
hold on, sir.
This is the court order we got today. And it is very clear there is what is called subjective law. There are some laws for some and others for others. That is called impunity. What you are witnessing today is the height of impunity, complete height of impunity, on top of persecution. This is persecution. And I want to tell you this persecution that began many years ago, all the way back in 2014 when this Jubilee government got to power. I want to say, as just my good friend here, the court clerk, has told, power has an expiry date. It is coming. It is very near. And I want to tell those that believe that persecution of their fellow Kenyans and impunity on their fellow Kenyans, that they shall face the wrath of God. It is coming. It is clear. And they shall face it clearly and loudly. Thank you very much.
Display. What have they told you they're arresting you on? What are they arresting you on?